back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show with me, Simon Au. Remember, the show repeats on Saturdays at 8 in the morning, so feel free to watch the repeat and learn something about how to improve your business, plus the basics that you need to beat your next competitor. Remember, your competitor is not entirely a bad person. He is a platform, or she is a platform, from which you can learn from. If there are things they're doing right and they're winning clients, you might want to interest yourself and start doing exactly that to be a better business person. Let's talk about how to make money. And to Value Addition this week, we're talking how mixing mushroom and making out porridge is something that is making some money for some young man. Let's run you through how to make money this week.
Business strategist, 7 years of experience.
Okay.
We came up with this product, and we gave it a name, Unahi Mushroom Composite Porridge Flour.
Mm.
Why? We didn't just add value on mushrooms and pumpkin seeds and oats.
Yeah.
We looked at why do we need to add value, because if we just added value, we would not have a market segment to target. You would just target everyone. So we needed that reason why the mushroom porridge.
That is very unique. You know what, let's first build on from there. So you are saying you didn't want to be like others in the market.
Yeah.
Is there some serious reason for being unique on the market?
Very. When it comes to the pricing, when it comes to the demand, when it comes to relevance. Mm.
So you chose not to just add value, but to go an extra niche so you can be unique on the market. So it's very important for people starting businesses.
And not even on the market, to be relevant, the population. When we get this product out, we are 100% sure we are relevant to your body system.
Okay.
Not just taking in food on a daily basis, but we are being relevant to your body system.
A business strategist, so how did you end up here?
Why I ended up here? At the time, we Ugandans or Africans, we want to start a business venture because you started a business venture. You sell techno phones here, I want to sell techno phones nearby. So when it comes to competition, there is nothing you're adding onto your business than just getting what you're supposed to get.
Does that explain probably why some people start quick businesses and fail, saying I'm not getting anything in the market?
Very true. Because you have not put in the creativity. You have not asked yourself why this. I looked at so many businesses to start, and I had potential being those many businesses. But I said no. At this opportune time, I needed to look at the growing industry so that I grow with that industry. Not involving myself in an industry that is at the peak, because I'll add nothing to that industry. When you grow with a growing industry, you get a lot of experience. Then you grow. So by the time it reaches the peak, when people are now yearning to join that industry, you have benefited 100% out of it.
All right.
Why the mushroom industry?
Exactly.
I am so lucky to be one of the experts in growing mushrooms. I have been in the mushroom industry for over 7 years. I was trained to grow mushrooms when I had left, when I was in senior five.
More like a family business?
Kind of? Not a family business.
Just
I picked interest. I paid, I think it was around 300,000.
In senior five?
Yes. To learn to grow mushrooms. I made research and I advise those who prove to be seniors in the mushroom industry. Some of them come here for advice. Why? I picked interest. I made research. Because I was creative enough, I became an expert in the industry.
You know what? Just tell the viewers, because you see, you picked interest and made research. How important are those two key aspects to someone thinking of a business?
When you don't make thorough research on what you are going to invest in, sometimes you spend 1 year, 2 years, and you feel you entered the wrong business. So you want to invest in the other business. Look at the time you've spent for those 2 years. It means they are wasted.
That's right.
And time wasted is never regained. We have a very short period in this world. So you are going to another investment which you have seen some other person doing. So you also want to pick interest. I pray you don't waste another 2 years.
They become four wasted years.
Four wasted years. Instead of making research on a given business, you put in all your efforts, the persistence in it, you make that business grow. At the end of the day, you reap.
What's your turning point around there? Because looks, so several young people your age have ambitions, dreams, and just when they're about to take it, you know, they get such words of, you know, you won't make it. The other guys already selling porridge in the market. What do you think you're going to do that is unique, that you will win customers? What did you do around that point to get off that bed and start production?
When I got those phone calls, I called a friend of mine. He's a doctor in Japan. When I was making these mixtures, I consulted him. Because I'm not a doctor. I'm not a nutritionist. So I needed the general doctor who understands the body system. I told him I'm giving up. He said, why? The market is not appreciative. The cost of production is high. So they want me to sell beer the cost of production. I need to have a profit on it. He told me when you first made the samples, you never tested on any Uganda. You sent the samples to Nairobi, to me. I tested through my patients. I gave patients who are diabetic. I gave patients who had pressure. I gave the malnourished. I gave the underweight. I gave the starting children. I gave people with HIV, I gave the old aged, I gave the patients. They responded on the porridge. If Ugandans are not appreciating, try your best, we shall export this porridge.
About understanding your market, because I feel like at the time when you're saying Ugandans are not appreciative, is it because you had sold these things that are not appreciating in terms of we don't see the
demand?
The demand.
The demand
had dropped.
The sales margin were not growing because they were not looking at the value. They were looking at the price. So the other friend of mine is telling me, look at the value. Insist on the value.
Not the price.
Not the price.
First of all, not to necessarily drop to the common market price just to fit in, stick with what you think is worth what you're selling.
When we are in school, I just guess you also recall, there are people who we used to call commoners.
I know them.
So, if you don't understand your value,
yeah,
someone will take advantage of you. Know your worth. I know my worth. I know the worth of that flower. So I sat down and said, okay, if Ugandans are not appreciative,
okay,
this guy has told me we shall export this flower. Now I'm making production for export. Export where, I don't know. Because I've got the courage.
Yes.
I said, those ones who will appreciate, they will take. Those ones who don't appreciate, it's up to them.
All right, so you know what? Let's then talk about the porridge, because now we know, you know, it's important to do research, it's important to know your market audience, it's important to know that pricing is not dependent on the forces in the market, but the product that you're selling.
Yeah.
Just don't lower your price because you want to be, you know, to get some customers. Tell us just how unique then this porridge is.
The uniqueness, one, is the mixture.
Which is?
We mix mushrooms.
The usual mushrooms.
They're the ones we grow, the oysters.
Okay.
Why we did the oyster mushrooms, and we didn't focus on the local mushrooms? Because there are people in Uganda who belong to a clan of those mushrooms. Mm. Actually, my mother is a clan of mushrooms.
So they don't eat them.
So the first person I consulted before is my grandmother. I went to the village. I start now, of the two, which one is a clan of your children? She said, this one is okay, this one we eat.
Mm.
But the local ones, they don't eat. I told her, you prove to me that you eat. She cooked them, she served them. I came back. Now, it is not about the mushrooms. It is not about the pumpkin seeds. It is not about the oats. It is not about the soil. It is about what do you need to have at the end of the day. We eat chicken fried.
Yeah.
We go and serve other things in restaurants. We feed the body. But have you ever asked yourself, how many nutrients do you need to have on a daily basis? Or you just serve matoke, rice, posho, beans, meat, everything.
I think it's more of the size. Just serve what is enough.
Because it is there.
Yeah, it's there.
So we looked at which has what.
Yep.
Fine, we grow mushrooms. Mm-hmm.
So?
What do they have? The mushrooms has most of the minerals. The mushrooms has most of the vitamins. It has the saturated fat the body needs. It has low calories, a single item. It has less of zinc. It has less of potassium. It has less of folate. So the body needs the three in full capacity. So the pumpkin seeds come in.
I get it now.
Not just the pumpkin seeds. Now the pumpkin seeds come.
Okay.
Then the oats come in. So we would have three components in this flour. But when you combine the three, they do not taste.
Do they just sour? No taste at all?
The taste is just there.
Okay. So what then triggers you?
So the Nairobi people responded on the flour. But it was not tasty. So the other colleague of mine told me, they will not buy it because it is not tasty. Nature of Africans. But we want it to be pure organic. So I thought of soya. I called him, I've thought of soya, deeply roasted. Do kids need the roasted soya? He told me they need roasted soya, but they don't need the raw soya. So I got 1% of the entire solution. I added soya roasted. I sent back. They tested, they liked the porridge, it responded. So that's why we have the mushrooms, the pumpkin seeds, the oats, and the soya.
You know, I pick something off what you just said, and again, I will ask, what is the relevance of investing in a business before starting a business?
The relevance of investing, so that you do not waste time. You might create something like this, you put on market. Mm. At the end of the day, you have either to make some changes, either it has not peaked, either what. So invest and come up with a final product. Prove it, test it. It is a bit costly.
Yeah.
To get this packet and give it out for free.
That's right. But you want,
you want to
in the long
the
run. Yes.
You want to prove the worth. Is it worth?
So the thing here is business people should not always look at the short term.
If you look at the short term, yeah, the returns will be short term. Look at the short term, returns will be short term. Mm. Most porridge flours on the market, they have flavors. They are flavored. Most, they are flavored.
But this is organic.
This is not flavored. People want the kawo, eh?
Yeah, it has the kawo.
But the kawo and the aroma, they are different.
That's right. So, what is your production capacity right now, and how do you get the raw materials?
One, we are growing mushrooms on a large scale, but when the porridge peaked, I couldn't divide myself. So I put a small demonstration farm in Kagoma at my mother's place. Then I remained with training how to grow. Those I can monitor, so that I pick mushrooms from you when they're well dried with a solar dryer, so that I don't find stones,
yeah,
dust. Because the nature of customers we have, most of them, they are corporate clients. And I was shocked that most of them buy their porridge flour for their children from Nairobi.
You don't say. So that's a market for you, I must think.
Why? Because they don't see value. The 4 years time, I penetrated, or I broke even in the very beginning of COVID-19.
You couldn't believe it.
COVID-19. Patients of COVID-19 consume the flour like crazy.
So when the experts are done talking and you have learned how to make money, the most important thing is how to save the money, or do you reinvest it? That is what we want to talk about this week on Personal Finance Tips. It's a whole chain of things. So how the tips, the different market environment, how to make money, and now how to invest the money. These are the tips this week for personal finance management.
Welcome to this segment as we talk about investment once again, and please introduce yourself.
Thank you, Cynthia. Charles Katongole, Head of Financial Markets with Standard Chartered Bank.
Okay, thanks. So we've been talking about investments, and today we are talking about something very interesting, retirement.
Mm-hmm.
Retirement. We hear it all the time, and when we are younger, we don't think it's important because we still have time. So first of all, tell us, what is retirement?
Well, it's a very interesting question. And I think it's different for everyone. Your definition of what retirement is will definitely be different from mine, will be different from anyone else watching and listening. But I guess the best way I can really define it, for me, retirement would be that ability for you to be able to do what you want, when you want, for however long you want, with whoever you want. So you're in a space where you choose what to do, when to do it, how to do it, with who to do it, for how long, however long you want to do it, without impacting your life. I'll give an example. If I wanted to go and watch Chelsea play Arsenal, watch Chelsea beat Arsenal repeatedly, can I do that on Monday, on Tuesday, and I want to go with my family, you understand, and sit at the beach? Can I do that? If I can do that without impacting my life, I think
you would have achieved your retirement goal.
I would have achieved retirement.
Oh, wow.
Now, if I'm not in that space, I may stop working. Because so you haven't retired.
Hmm.
All you've done is changed employers.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So as I said, it's different for everyone. But in my view, for me, it's you retire when you get into that space where you don't have pressure. You're in a good space where you do the things you want when you want, with whoever you want, for however long you want to do it, and that's not impacting the rest of your life.
Oh, wow.
Then you have retired.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I find that so interesting and so insightful, and a different way of looking at retirement.
Mm-hmm.
So how should one start planning for retirement?
Yeah. And I guess once we've now defined what retirement is, what you're really doing is buying time.
Okay.
As in saving time, for lack of a better word. You want to save time and resources for you to be able to enjoy that freedom. So we work backwards. So I want to be able to do the things I want when I want. When do I want to be able to do that? So I want to be able to do that in 5 years. Now, in 5 years, would I have built sufficient backstock or resources to allow me to do that and to do that for the rest of my life?
Okay.
So that's how I'd really approach it. If I realize I won't be able to, then that means that my retirement time is not going to be 5 years. It's going to be maybe 10, 15, 20 years, maybe 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing you need to consider is we're living longer, way longer. I think the average age, I think it must be north of 60 now, the life expectancy for Ugandans. And take into consideration that we have high child mortality, so all that is going there. High maternal, it's coming down, yeah? But once you factor in all those, yeah, then you realize that 65 probably means for people who are maybe living well, you're feeding properly, you're probably going to live, chances are that you live to your 70s and 80s. Yeah? Now, usual active employment stops at, by law, I think it's 60. So chances are that you still have an extra 20 something years within which to live and be able to do the things you want. So you need to build a buffer that would probably cover you beyond active employment for those that are actively employed. Or you need to start accelerating that building of that reserve if it's not. Say, let's assume that when you leave active employment or whatever you're doing, your monthly costs are what? Let's say 1 million shillings. That's what you're living with. So you want to be able to maintain, as I said, without affecting your life, you want to be able to maintain that cost base. Now, if you want to travel, as you mentioned, what is it, the place that people like going? The ladies?
Bahamas.
Santorini, is it? Yeah, in
I know
Greece.
Bahamas.
Bahamas. Yeah, so you need to be able to sponsor that. And remember, you're not actively employed or engaged anymore.
Yes.
So you need to be
so
able to.
So how do you
that.
Build the pool? Talk about, for instance, I hear pension. What types of pensions are there?
Yeah. So we've defined the time.
Yes.
We've defined what you need.
Okay.
In terms of the actual cash that you'd probably need to expend. You have defined that. Now you need the asset to generate that income. So we do have the National Pension Scheme.
First, what's NSSF. An asset?
An asset is something that produces economic value.
Okay.
Over time. Economic value for any, lack of a better word, something that generates money.
Whatever brings money in my pocket.
Yeah, whatever
is
generates,
an
that's an asset for you.
Cool.
If it generates
okay.
money, it's
mm-hmm.
it's an
so
asset
continuing.
On your side. So we've worked out the time you want to retire, so you're working backwards. You know how much you need for you to sustain that life and fun that you want. Now you build that asset
okay.
that's going to generate that income for you.
To the Forex now, and the shilling started relatively firm against the dollar. Of course, there's been so much trading. We can hope that things can stabilize in the near future. Let's give you the comprehensive report of the Forex and money market report. I guess there's not much, so much to say for now. Thank you so much for making time. Otherwise, from us here and the rest of the team, we're glad you could make time. Feel free to get in touch with us. Our socials are right below your screen. So drop us those comments. Tell us what you think about the show, plus the things that you feel are very important for you as a business person. I'll be more than glad to respond. So much happened through the week, including insurance and boosting savings culture amongst Ugandans. There's a whole conversation of institutional savings. So Bank of Uganda is moving around a piggy bank to different institutions per year, and the competition is simple. Every institution will be saving, and at the end of the year we shall be seeing who would have won. Some interesting stuff. We can only hope that this can actually be put down, you know, even to the basic Ugandans, the ordinary Ugandans I should say, so we can encourage people to save generally. My name is Simon. I'll see you soon from me and the team. It's bye-bye.